Hi, I'm with Alice Hume, and we're at an exhibition which is our Interactive Weaves, and it's a project she's been working on for some time now. And I'd just like to say, nice to meet you, Alice. And do you want to just tell us a little bit about the exhibition you have here?
Yeah, of course. So I started this project the end of 2019. I got Arts Council funding. It got postponed, so I've started again this year, but I've had nearly 500 people involved. I've run workshops at Hotwalls Studios, got 21 Hotwalls Studio artists to run workshops, do painting, and just get the community together.
Wow, I mean,
it's been amazing.
That sounds like a lot of work. How have you found that side of it?
Yeah, I don't think I've ever worked so hard in my life, but I've absolutely loved it. It's been such a joy.
And out of the workshops, I can see around here you've got a load of photos of the various different people. What was the experience of actually interacting with all those people, kind of seeing them, you know, produce the art that you're encouraging to?
Yeah, incredible. I think, I encourage people to write messages after they've done a workshop or they did some weaving. So just being able to hear 500 voices of strangers and complete range of people was just so moving. Some of the messages are just really, really moving.
Absolutely.
Lovely ideas.
And this is your teepee?
Yeah, so I did a teepee at Victorious Festival. Had over 200 people come have a go in 3 days. I was in the world music area. Yeah, it was brilliant. So much fun.
Actually, having a look at some of the comments, one of the things that I'm a massive advocate of is the benefit of art on mental health.
Yeah.
And actually just reading some of these very personal comments, you can see that it's, even though maybe it's not in a spreadsheet, but it really does show the impact of the way art can help people.
Yeah, especially with COVID in the past 18 months, I think people have realised how important art and doing community projects is for your mental health and your well-being. And some people attended the workshops and strangers exchanged phone numbers afterwards. It's just really lovely.
Fantastic. So this has been an awful lot of work.
So much work.
And we were
had
just
a lot of help.
In fact, that was it. So you were just saying that most of this installation you've managed to get done for, frankly, very little money.
Yeah, so I managed to scavenge a ton of materials, plants. I got rope from Boathouse 4 in the dockyard, the bamboos from a friend that grows it in his garden. All the plants are waste plants from friends from their gardens. So I've actually only spent £3, which is on blue tack, because that's the only way I could stick the photos to the fishing line.
So your passion behind doing this project is clearly very strong.
Yeah.
And what is it that you hope it achieves?
Just inspiration and ideas, really. Loads of people come in here and they see something different and they kind of go home, oh, I want to start my art classes again, or I want to, you know, make a little forest weave in my garden. That's what I love the most, is what people take from it.
And how can people find out more about your work?
On my website, follow Interactive Weaves. If you Google Interactive Weaves, you'll find all the information.
Fantastic. Thank you for your time, Alice.
Thank you.